Hello everybody and welcome to Unknown Empire SMP episode 52. Today we are going to be taking a bit of a break from the story events because that's pretty much all that's been going on for the past few episodes, and that's all that's going to be going on for the next bunch. So yeah, we are here in Traveler's Landing, nothing special here except for Gary, new parrot that I found in the Skult jungle. But that's not what we're here for. What we are here for is to look at a bunch of off-camera builds that I have done, and I'm sure you're wondering, you know, why off-camera? Well, I've kind of found that it's kind of distracting doing them on camera, so I'm sorry to those of you who like to see the entire building process and all that jazz, but I find it's a lot better for me not having to worry about commentary while I build. So yeah, I did a bunch of builds off camera. Hello, cat. Poor guy. He's waiting to be unleashed at the right time. But anyway, I have maybe five to seven. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff. But yeah, the first one is right down here, Skult Lounge. So let's just play a funky music disc. I found another one of these. Malohi. It's perfectly spooky for the Skult Tunnel, so that's why I put it here. But this is the Skult Lounge. There's really not much to it. I put the Skult Hounds down here because things were getting annoying up there with all the mobs, and they just wouldn't stay where they were supposed to. So yeah, this was very spontaneous, and I just wanted this to look a lot better than it did, because this room was like really nothing before. Just some storage for miscellaneous materials, which it kind of still is. But yeah, it's all right. We got magma blocks right here, painting, a couch thing, and yeah, anvil and stuff. So basically everything that was already here, but now it has more pizzazz. And I think that's it for the Skult Temple, really. There's everything down there is the same. I lit up the prison with redstone torches instead of normal torches, but I showed you guys that last episode. So yeah, just a little thing here, but there's a bunch of more interesting stuff in these next few places we're going to visit. The theme with a lot of the builds that I've constructed this episode is that they are more or less kind of secret. Like, they're definitely not obvious at all, and you never see them unless you're close. Like, for instance, this next one in Valdera, as you can see, you go past What's-Your-Face Jerry, always forget his name, and chickens. We have employees only up here. Now, this has been here ever since Toby built the place, and there's been nothing inside until a few couple episodes ago when I put this zombie villager in here. But now we have this little room right here, Skult Quests, with Victor as the, I don't know, the quest giver, whatever you want to call him. And we've got this purple symbol back here. But he won't get out of the way. Jeez, Victor. But anyways, we got these new banners, which kind of represents, like, the combined Skult and Palumbran Empire type of deal. Maybe it'll be my official banner when I take over Eztin. But anyway, yeah, this is gonna be, like, next time I give a quest to Claude or something, I'll just start them off in here. I haven't really worked out all the details with this yet, but yeah, it's kind of spooky. Gave this little room a purpose to be open only to employees, which basically means just Skult members. So the next bundle of builds is here in the Lost Kingdom, which I don't think I've really been here on camera in a while, at least not significantly. But this was one of the bunch of banners that I made that one time when I got bored. So yeah, I hung some of these up, and the thing I did here, because as you can see, Forge had built a ton of these buildings already, but a lot of them didn't have finished interiors. So one of the builds that I did was a Skult headquarters. I made a couple of these, and basically in here, I mean, it's not really complex or anything, but we got a little meeting table over here, some acacia to set this building apart from the rest, some banners all over the place, and you know, just a seat up here. Nothing special, but in here, well, that kind of spoiled it. I swear I closed that door, but yeah, it looks like a bedroom until you see this. Another Skult shrine, and at this point, I believe there are 5 of them that I've constructed. The master shrine and the temple, and then the 4 others in various places, mostly along, like, the northern, southern middle of the map, kind of. Yeah, but anyway, that's basically it for that. And the other things, they're not exactly done. I attempted to finish this castle, like, the interior, because the only thing that's done, I believe, is the library at the very top floor, but I can never find out how to get inside of that thing without breaking the blocks up at the top. But, yeah, I tried working on things like the servants' quarters and a couple other things, but I just don't have the materials to finish this place, and while Forge did label a lot of the rooms, I don't really know how to go about finishing them. So, I don't really know if I'm going to finish this place, but yeah, I attempted this and I ran out of jungle slabs. I don't really know what I was planning to do in there, but yeah, this castle's massive, and I seriously doubt that I'm going to finish the whole thing. So, maybe an idea I had was, like, we do a build event in here, but honestly, there's a lot of places like Traveler's Landing that kind of need to be finished building-wise, and they're probably not going to get visited, all of them, because, as you know, the end of the season is just about here. So, yeah, I don't know how much more time we have on this map, but its days are numbered. And there's an ocelot over there. I do not have any fishies left. Okay, well, have fun over there, cat. But yeah, I finished these stairs on here as well, because it was annoying going up this thing. But this farmhouse down here, I didn't put a sign on it, but I put more banners here, and this place had, like, no interior whatsoever, but I touched it up, I made the entire structure, and I put some hay blocks and stuff, but that's really the extent of it. There's some rooms and stuff, you know, floors, ceilings. All these rooms are empty, though. And there's, like, 4 floors. Oh! Okay. But yeah, there is nothing in there. I think there might be, like, one thing up here. Dark's room. Yeah, this is what I kind of intended it to be. But there's, yeah, that's pretty much it for this. But I did finish the interior because you could just see, like, all the way up to the roof from down here before. And I don't think I showed that, the before picture, on camera, but yeah, that's what that was. And that's it, pretty much it for the Lost Kingdom, one of my other territories that was given to me along with Voldera. And now I have some really kind of secret stuff. So it just occurred to me that pretty much, like, every build I did was Skult-themed, but this is the one that absolutely nobody knows about and nobody would really expect. Not even Claude knows about this one, but I guess if he watches the video, he will, and so will everyone else. But this is Toby's original house right here, like his very first build, and it's just hiding behind the police station. You know, no one can see it anymore unless you actually go back here. So I thought, what a perfect place to build something extra secret. So, you know, it looks like, you know, just an average house. No one would suspect a thing, but, you know, if you look through the doors, maybe I should replace those. But you got another Skult shrine. This is the 5th of the 5, and it's kind of like the, oh, maybe I should finish the ceiling. Yeah, this was just, like, a random thought I had, like, yesterday, and then I built it, and it's even numbered, so the shrine is kind of unusual. But yeah, you got the typical 4 skulls on the nether brick, or the nether wart brick, whatever you call that, and then this mesa red chiseled sandstone with the wither on it, and then this is also an Agatha's camp. I don't really know what to call that, but yeah, this is like the secret shrine. I'll probably do, like, some sort of Skult quest revolving around the 5 shrines of the Skult. But yeah, that's just the little thing in Waypoint I did last minute because, I don't know, I guess I just needed something else to fill the episode. Alright, so my last build is here in Wellspire, and this is the one that I've kind of talked about because, I don't know, it's the most relevant in terms of the, I don't know, the probability that other people might come across it, and which is the Skult Spire. And this is to kind of celebrate the fact that the Skult was founded in Wellspire. That's probably a little known fact among, you know, everybody, but in fact I kind of forget about it sometimes. But yeah, this is kind of where the Skult was born. It was this whole thing. If my footage from episode 2 didn't corrupt, you guys would have seen it, but yeah, it was hilarious. I don't really know how to describe it, but it's in, I think, one of Minnie's videos somewhere. I have no idea what number it is, but yeah, the Skult Spire right here, and I think the only person besides me who has seen this is Minnie, and I don't think anyone's seen the rest of these builds, but yeah, the way you get in here is great, and you can tell which spire it is because of the redstone things, and there is another portal over there. But anyway, the way you get in is you go up the water, and then you go down this middle part, and it's kind of tricked up a few people. And the way I built this was kind of weird. You got this level, like, that you can see the bottom of the lake with, and then I was originally going to put, like, all of the special stuff on this level, but then I realized it was still too close to the surface, so I kind of made this just whatever it is. But then I had to make this level down here, and the Skult Spire is probably my favorite of the new builds, just because of how, I don't know, it's more complex than the rest, I guess. But it's got four rooms, and the first is the treasure vault, and the treasure vault's got lapis, gold, emerald, redstone, all the riches and stuff. I do have diamonds and stuff, but not that many, and there's no way I'm gonna use diamond blocks in a build. I'm sorry, but they're just too valuable to me. And then let's see, which one should we go to next? Let's go to the Skult Shrine. This is another one. I had like two Skult Shrines before, and now I had five, so yeah, here's three of them. And I told you where another one was, and you can probably guess where the last one is, but yeah, this one, they all look kind of different, which I kind of like. This one could have had more effort put into it, and maybe at some point I'll mess with it some more. Probably not, honestly, but yeah, this is the smallest one by far, but you know, there's a bunch of stuff in here. So meeting room, this is nothing too special. Three banners, a table, kind of like the Lost Kingdom one, except it has more chairs and some iron bars. So yeah, it's I don't know, it's not bad. I don't know, some people say I underrate myself with my builds. I don't have any confidence in myself whatsoever, but anyway, this is my favorite room of the Skult Spire, the Palumbran artifacts, which is some stuff that I just kind of made up. But you go in here, and as you can see, we got the banners of the gods and the courts and everything. It's a special room. So we got a Tristan's banner, this is Zovan's banner, and Tatris's banner. I'm sure you guys all know what this one looks like by now. But there's all some interesting lore-esque stuff in these chests. So this is a Rannoch's battle axe, chest plate, and shield. And you guys won't know who this is unless you've watched some of the other people on the server, because 1 week a story event got canceled, so Kento made like a backup story event that kind of introduced people to some season 3 characters that somehow made their way over here, and there was no one else on to play the character, so I volunteered to play Rannoch, which is like this grumpy Viking guy. He's like, I don't know, you don't want to make him mad, he's kind of dangerous, but you know, obviously I killed him because I got his gear, so no. But yeah, he and Claude had a disagreement, and we agreed that if he ever met Darkblade or Skulton or any of the super evil Skult guys, he'd be doomed. So yeah, he thinks he's all that, but if he ever met like the Skult elites, he'd be in trouble. But then we got this chest over here, and this is some, like, I don't know what to call these souvenirs. Like, we got Gordon's pastry, Drew's fishing rod, Sev's string. These are all after my mob characters, by the way. Jeff the chef's first burrito, because he's the bandito burrito chef. Dogblade's chewing bone, Ned and Ted's slime ball, Cubert's cream. Jack's hammer, because he's the blacksmith. Bart's beer mug, and Kevin's book. And, yeah, so those are also mobs that have made some appearances. And these are, those are more like just, I don't really know how to describe them. Just things that they use, and these are more like weapon kind of things in here for more of the skulty or spooky guys that I have. So we got General Pumpig's helmet, Deadeye's eye, Frostbite's arrow, Commander Cryo's bow, Tombstone's victim, probably one of the guards he's chewed up or something from Tatchet, I don't know. Maybe that's the guard from the Invasion of Reverie that the dogs killed. But we got Lieutenant Lefty's sword here, Doug's Ender Pearl, because he's the guy who's keeping an eye on the Mason Kingdom, Skulton's cursed blade, and Agatha's glowstone dust. So, yeah, there may or may not be more stuff added to this if I can come up with it, but, yeah, that's the Skult Spire, and that's the last build that I have to show you guys. So I don't know if you guys prefer that I do these off-camera, or if you want to see the whole building process, because I gotta be honest, I prefer doing them off-camera. They just, I mean, I kind of said this before, but probably not very well. I just feel like I can get a lot more done, at least, if I'm not worrying about commentary and recording and all that stuff, because I feel a bit rushed if I have to do it on video, and then it doesn't really turn out the way I want to, or at least not exactly, I don't know, but I just like it better this way. And I gotta say, though, thank God for shulker boxes, because without this thing, this would have been a whole lot more difficult to construct. And, yeah, I got a bunch of leftover beds from the castle, and I recolored it. But, yeah, that's pretty much it for all of my builds, guys. Alright, everybody, that is going to do it for this episode. I hope you all enjoyed, and I decided to film the outro in Sephir because there's one last banner to show, but, and I guess there's a few more in Plartica, but they haven't been used, but anyway, that is it for my off-camera builds. I hope you guys liked them, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye! Guys, we may have a problem.